Hello and greetings to all. Today we will discuss about a very basic topic of boiler, that is boiler purge and its significance. First of all, we will see why boiler purge is required. Purge, as the name implies, is nothing but the cleaning of system before taking it into operation. Purging can be understood as scavenging of any system. It is simply cleaning of system before taking it into operation. With purging, we clear off any residual unburnt fuel so as to avoid furnace explosion due to sudden burning of large amount of fuel at the time of flight up. Significance of purging. Purging is the main permissive for boiler light up. As if purging is not done, then there will be no permissive for boiler light up. So permissive for boiler light up is purging. Boiler purging time is set at 5 minutes. Why this time is set at 5 minutes? This is because it ensures proper removal of unburnt fuel particles to be transported outside boiler furnace. The procedure of boiler purging is clearly shown in this picture. The clean air is provided by force draught fan or secondary air fan or FD air fan. This clean air is pumped into boiler furnace. At the other end, ID fan or induced draught fan creates a negative suction which pulls out this fresh air along with the unburnt fuel and transport it to the stack or chimney. In this way, the unburnt fuel is transported from boiler furnace to the atmosphere. As we all know, in power plant, for each and every operation, there are certain permissives. Likewise, boiler purge also have some permissives. For ease of operation, we have divided these permissives into four major parts. The first major part is no boiler trip condition should be persisting. The second one is no fuel supply equipment should be running. Third one is no flame should be sensed by any flame scanner in boiler furnace. And fourth one is airflow should be greater than 30% and less than 40%. Further, in the upcoming slides, we will see description of each and every boiler purge permissive. The first condition among boiler purge permissive is no boiler trip condition should be persisting. Boiler trip, in other words, we can say MFT or master fuel trip. There are certain conditions due to which MFT occurs. Among these conditions are all ID fans off, all FD fans off, drum level high or low, airflow less than 30%, furnace pressure high or very low. If one or more of these conditions are persisting, then MFT will be true. In that case, we cannot go ahead with boiler purging. So before going for boiler purging, we have to normalize all these conditions. If you want any additional information regarding MFT, kindly refer to my another tutorial on master fuel trip. The second boiler purge permissive is no fuel supply equipment should be running. As we have already discussed that the main purpose of boiler purging is to remove unburnt fuel from furnace. So any fuel supply equipment running or any fuel supply valve in open condition is not desirable. So to avoid that, we should have all LOTV and LONV in closed conditions. LOTV is nothing but light oil trip valve. LOTV is a single valve in LDO main supply line. LONV is light oil nozzle valve. This valve is provided at every corner before oil guns. Next, all HOTV and HONV should be in closed condition. HOTV is nothing but heavy oil trip valve. Like LOTV, HOTV is also a single valve which is provided in HFO main supply line. HONV is heavy oil nozzle valve. Like LONV, HONV is a valve which is provided at every corner before oil guns. Apart from this, the other conditions are all PA fan should be in off, all cold feeders off, all mill hot air gate should be in closed position. The third boiler purge permissive is no flame should be sensed by flame scanner. The picture in this slide shows the location of flame scanner situated at every corner and at every elevation of boiler. This graphical representation is typically for 270 MW plant or 890 TPH ton of boiler. There may be more elevations in case if the boiler is for a 600 MW plant. So if any one of these flame scanner sense flame in boiler, then we will not get any permissive for boiler purging. Fourth boiler purge permissive condition is total airflow should be greater than 30% and less than 40%. This condition ensures adequate airflow inside boiler furnace, which is required to transfer unburned fuel to stack or chimney. As we have discussed earlier in previous slide, if airflow is less than 30%, then the MFT condition will be true. So if airflow is less than 30%, then we cannot go for boiler purging. So for boiler purging, it is required that airflow should be maintained above 30% and less than 40%. So friends, this is the complete logic of boiler purging. Through this logic, we can clearly understand the conditions and permissives of boiler purging. All these conditions are routed through an AND gate. This means all of these conditions are required to go for boiler purging. If any one of these conditions does not meet, then we cannot go for purge start. Once all of these conditions are true, then we can go for purge start. A 5-minute purging cycle will start and boiler will purge completely. In between this 5-minute cycle, during the time of purging, if any of this condition goes false, then in that case the purging will halt. In technical terms, if purge halts midway, then it is called as purge interrupt. In that case, we have to find out the condition due to which this purge interruption occurred. After finding out this cause, we have to clear this cause and normalize all the system. Then again we can start the purge from the point it was stopped. This picture clearly depicts the condition before purging and after boiler purging. Before boiler purging, MFT, that is master fuel trip, is in true condition. When MFT is in true state, then it does not allow boiler to be lighted up. Also, there will be no boiler protection in service, as already master fuel trip is persisting. After completion of 5 minutes of purge cycle, MFT resets. Now, as the MFT is not persisting, we can go ahead for boiler light up. All boiler protections are in service. We will discuss about boiler light up in my next tutorial on boiler light up. We will soon come up with more technical discussion videos in future. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel Power Guide for more information and regular updates on new videos. In case of any query or suggestion, please leave a comment or write to powerguide16@gmail.com. Thank you.